Welcome to the service clinic at Low Country Harley-Davidson. I'm Doc Harley. I have received several questions on what is the best tuner for my Harley-Davidson. We need to back up from that question just for a moment and ask some other questions. The first question is your bike under warranty? If your bike is under warranty, you only have one choice. You can only use the Harley-Davidson tuner, the Pro Street Tuner, and you can add the Smart Tune Pro to make the Street Pro Performance Tuner a little bit better. Why can I only use this? Is because your warranty is covered by Harley-Davidson products. And if you tune with any other system that changes the ECM internally, then when you bring your Harley-Davidson to any dealer, let's say you're on a road trip and you have an issue and they hook up their Harley-Davidson computer, if it searches through your ECM and finds something different in your ECM because you tuned it, it's going to send a note to the factory directly black flagging your powertrain. Your powertrain, your motor, your primary, your transmission, your belt, and possibly the rear wheel. Yeah, that's a lot of coverage that might be gone. Your bike will be black flagged that if you have an issue dealing with one of those, then Harley-Davidson will review it. And they have the choice of saying, nope, you changed something and didn't keep it under the factory warranty. We're gonna deny your warranty. So, first question, is your bike under warranty? If it is, use only Harley-Davidson products so you can travel and keep your warranty as you are using your bike for the 2-year warranty. Now, if you don't care about your warranty, or you have a used bike that you've picked up or something that you wanna tune up, all right, let's ask the important questions. Why do you want a tuner? Did you just change your mufflers? If you just change your mufflers and the air cleaner is stock and the motorcycle is stock, you don't need to tuner because the Harley-Davidson ECM, the electronic control module, has a 10% window. It'll read the O2 sensors. The O2 sensors will say, you're running a little bit lean. It'll add up to 10% of fuel to compensate for your mufflers, and you're good to go. Now, if you change the air cleaner and add more air to an already lean running motorcycle from the factory, now we need a tuner. We need some way of adding fuel to your motorcycle to compensate for all this extra air that's coming in and out. Next question you have to ask yourself is, how much do I want to spend for a tuner? And then the next question really quickly is, what do I want to do to my motorcycle? Am I just putting the muffler and air cleaner and that's it? I'm not going to do anything more. I just want to ride my motorcycle. All right, we can keep the costs low and we won't have to invest in something that you don't need. But if you're thinking about, okay, I'm gonna do a muffler and I'm gonna do air cleaner, and then, boy, I've been talking with my friends and they put a cam in their motorcycle that really changed the motorcycle, and then this other guy put a stage 4 in it, it starts really getting out of hand. But if you have desires for more power, then you have to choose a tuner that can grow with you, because you don't want to spend money on this tuner and then change to this tuner and then change to this tuner. You want to buy something that can stay with your motorcycle and grow with your motorcycle. So let's go back to the question of cost. All right, all I'm going to do is change my muffler and air cleaner, and I don't have that much money. There are products on the market that act like a carburetor tuner. These have little pots on it that are like low speed, mid, and high, and you add a little bit fuel to these sections. The problem is they're foolers. What they do is they go in between the injectors, and then the signal comes from the Harley-Davidson product. It goes through this and fools it and says, no, I want you to add a little bit more fuel. Okay, and then it goes through. And this can sometimes work, except with this type of unit, you need to disconnect your O2 sensors. And that can sometimes flag if you don't put something inside the O2 sensors to say, oh, I'm still here, but you're really not here. But you can't have the stock Harley-Davidson O2 sensors reporting back to the electronic control module, because I'm turning it up richer, my O2 sensors say, oh, it's too rich, let's lean it out. I'm richer, I'll lean, and it's a fight. It's back and forth, and it doesn't work. So you have to take the O2 sensors out so the electronic control module says, okay, I'm doing it. Another product that you can add is the Power Commander. There was the early Power Commander 3 and the Power Commander with the 5. And these products fool the electronic control module. They're in between the electronic control module and everything else. So what the electronic control module tells the motorcycle to do, it says, no, 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 I want a little richer. I want this a little stuff. This works, but it's fooling the motorcycle. And let me explain to you, Harley-Davidson electronic control module, when you turn on the motorcycle, it goes through the whole system and says, is everybody online? All the sensors are good. All this is good. And when it comes to the fooler, it goes, whoa, whoa, wait a minute. It's supposed to be 1.4 resistance, and I'm getting 0.5. I'll let it go now, but I'm going to keep monitoring this. And we have found that when you put a fooler on a Harley-Davidson, in a one-year period of time, the Harley-Davidson will stop and say, I'm not going to accept this number anymore, and your bike won't start. And you have to do is disconnect all this, put it back stock, and the bike will fire up, except that you've got these exhaust pipes and the air cleaner and all that, and the stock electronic mapping is not going to be good for it. So know this. Yes, this is low cost in getting in, but you're fooling it, and you're really not telling the motorcycle you need to keep the extra fuel. So cost-wise, you're here. Now, the next step up, cost, and also the question comes up, how computer savvy are you? How much do you know about fuel injection? Do you know about where to add fuel and where not to add fuel, where not to touch the ignition, and where to maybe possibly change the ignition? You have to ask the honest question. How much do you want to play with this motorcycle, and how much do you know? Because when you go to the next step in changing the motorcycle, you better know what you're doing, because you can hurt your motorcycle. The next step up, and a very popular, is the fuel pack. If you look on Google, you'll find this is almost the number one system that people are purchasing. It's because it's so simple. Plugs into the data port. And what happens is you put an app on your phone, and you can use the app to look at everything on your motorcycle. It's a fantastic thing that helps you look at everything going on, but it gives you the capability of adding fuel, changing things here and there. You better know what you're doing. Yes, it has canned maps. Let me back up a little bit. All of tuning devices have canned maps. That means they're generically improved, but they work on several different motorcycles. Let's say you own a Heritage Softail with slip-ons, but this other guy has a Fat Boy and has Vance and Hines pipes. There's only one map that goes for both of them. Are they correct for both? No. It needs to be tuned, needs to be addressed to that motorcycle. So you have starting base maps, and that's an important question to ask and look into. When you look into a tuner, do they have a base map for my motorcycle? Is my motorcycle too old for this tuner? Or does it not have my kind of pipe, my kind of air cleaner, my kind of cam? You got to ask important questions. So the fuel pack will work for you, but you better know what you're doing. The Achilles heel of the fuel pack we have seen too many times is you use the Auto Tune Pro in it, and it helps you tune your motorcycle, and you love your map, but you forget to turn the auto tune off, and your motorcycle runs in lean condition all the time, and you're upset at this and you throw it out. It's because you didn't know. You need to know each one of these. You need to know how it works and what you can do. Now, if you don't feel comfortable in tuning, you're an accountant, you love to ride, I'm not into tuning motorcycles, then you need to find the tuner in your area. Ask your friends, who tunes your motorcycle? Find the one that has the best reputation. Then go to your tuner and ask, what are you proficient in? What do you like using to tune your motorcycle? It might be Power Commander, it might be Pro Vision, it might be Thunder Max, it might be Harley-Davidson Screamin' Eagle, it might be TTS, it might be Wintec. There are so many tuners out there. And one tuner cannot be the best on all tuners. They have specialized on one particular tuner that they do best. Ask your tuner, which one? Because you could go on eBay and buy the most expensive TTS system and go to your tuner, and all he does is Power Commander. You've spent the money that really he cannot use. You've got great tuners, but you need to find the tuner and find out what he does best. Once you two discuss together what is the tuner for you, then you can choose the correct tuner for your motorcycle. On the market is TTS. TTS has a fantastic story in the past. TTS creator, Steve, created the street tuner for Harley-Davidson. And then Harley-Davidson went a separate direction, and TTS went their own direction. TTS products is fantastic. But in this little box, you can open up so much in your computer, you can get in so much trouble. This can really fine-tune your Harley-Davidson in any type of combination. Big bore, hot cam, exhaust systems, you name it, this can help tune. But you better have a tuner that knows what to touch and what not to touch on it. The Harley-Davidson product is good for Harley-Davidson stuff. If you go wild and go with a D&D exhaust or a wide open drag pipes, or you go with this high lift 600 lift cam, that's not in the wheelhouse of the Harley-Davidson tuner. Harley-Davidson products are in this tuner, and it can tune it very well to what the products are. But go out into the aftermarket and try to tune with this. Not anymore. Harley-Davidson has made this to be compliant with EPA, so you have to choose others. And the cost increases as you go with different tuners. Ending with the most expensive so far is the ThunderMax. The ThunderMax replaces your electronic control module. It is the computer that tunes. And it uses the wideband O2 sensors that the tuners at the dyno uses to tune. This is the most expensive way. But it also has its quirks that you have to learn on the ThunderMax. It comes with the base map, just like I told you before, base map that works on several different motorcycles. But once you start your motorcycle and start riding, it starts modifying the base map to your motorcycle. And I have had customers that say, oh, mine acts up at 3,000 RPM. Well, fine. Hold it at 3,000 RPM, and this will tune. You'll feel it. You'll feel it kind of hesitating at 3,000. You hold it there, and all of a sudden, it gets smooth, and it gets better. And you're going down the road, and you've made your map to you. The thing that people don't know about ThunderMax is you are modifying the base map. It is to your benefit that once a year, at least, you go to your tuner and say, can you commit this map? And then after that, it starts fine-tuning that map that it has been modifying to it. Each one of these has their pluses and minuses. You have to ask important questions. There are a lot of questions out there. I ask you to go on the forums, find out what people like and don't like about it, find out if you're capable of tuning with it at yourself. With many of these other high-priced ones, you have to have a computer that is compatible with the tuner. You have to have the knowledge to use that computer. In my early days when I was tuning, I had a long cable that went from my computer in the living room out the bedroom door and went to the motorcycle outside on the sidewalk. I had to change things that way. Now we've got laptops, which is great. You can go into the garage and tune yourself. There's nothing that can compare to a dyno tune. A great tuner on a dyno can replicate every situation and tune, where it's hard to replicate everything on the highway because you're going down the road and all of a sudden somebody slows down in front of you. Or you're going through the streets and trying to get it and all of a sudden there's a stop and you've got to sit there for 3 hours. Well, there's a lot of things on the street that don't allow you to tune to your best abilities. A dyno at least is a safe situation where you've got a great tuner who can get the best and the most out of your motorcycle. So I always endorse having a bike dyno tuned with a good tuner, but the tuner has to have the reputation and the qualities to be able to use the best benefits of your tuner that you purchased. I hope this answered some of your questions. I'm sure I'm going to receive a whole lot more questions. Do your research, check with your friends, check the reviews, and choose something that you can work with and that can work with your motorcycle. And remember the very first question, if your bike's under warranty, stay with the Harley-Davidson products so your warranty will be good for the remainder of your warranty. I'm Doc Harley. We'll see you next week.